The Connect Chicago Meetup is just a monthly gathering of digital equity advocates in Chicago, people that provide computer training, who run nonprofits, that train people in technology, anyone interested in or working in any ways to close technology gaps in our city. That's basically who we're interested in convening at these meetings and learning from. And so I know I've learned a lot about the different resources here in Chicago, and there's so much work going on all around the city that we just find it really useful to gather people together, learn what each other is doing, and also have a platform to connect, form partnerships, and innovate in general. And so thank you all. Thank you all for coming today. And actually, I've been really excited for this particular event, and I've had conversations with individuals here about it because we've had a lot of events this year about, you know, training seniors, youth in the arts, lots of skills-focused meetups, not as much about devices. And so, as many of you know, the digital divide and just digital inclusion in general requires, you know, access in general, so like low-cost monthly internet. It requires skills, so narrowing the skills gaps we see in our city. It also requires devices, either discounted or low-cost devices. And there's lots of great work happening in the city on this front. We also have we have Matt here from Free Geek, which is exciting, and we also have Sarah, who's going to present today, not only about her organization, PCRR, but how we can think about computer refurbishing in Chicago in general. And so I think this is going to be a really cool event. There are a lot of trainers in the audience, and so I would really challenge people to think about creative ways we can all partner and create like a pipeline to give people holistic services, not just training, but maybe also devices or low-cost devices. Great, so everyone should have these sheets. If you don't, raise your hand and we can give them to you, but these sheets just have the Wi-Fi info for you, the bathroom codes, which are near the elevators you might have seen when you came in. Feel free to get up throughout the meetup and get more food. There's a lot of food. We like to feed you. we also have live meetup notes. So the short code is right here on my right, and is on the piece of paper that is in front of you as well. So feel free to get on the notes, contribute to the notes, add an announcement or an event to the notes. If there's something you're hosting later this month, there's something that you just want the community to know about, please put it in the document. There also will be time at the end of the meetup. We reserve time for anyone to kind of just talk about what's going on, anything that you want other people to know, or something that you want to plug to this group, there will be time for that at the end. And then also, you're always welcome to tweet. So you can use the hashtag ConnectChicago, and you can tag SmartChicago and PCRR. Great, so we are wrapping up the welcome now, and we always start Connect Chicago meetups with an introduction. And so it's always just good to know everyone in the room, everyone's role, everyone's perspective, and then afterwards you can maybe connect with someone if you know your ears perk up and you realize you really need to talk to that one trainer or that one nonprofit. So we'll do that next. Then we'll hear from PCRR. We'll have a broader discussion about refurbishing and devices in Chicago, and then we'll reserve some time for community announcements. I'm also going to plug at the end, there are a few minutes, I'm going to reserve for some meetup feedback. And we might even do a little technology test. We have like this text voting system that we're using in Smart Chicago. If that fails, I have a paper backup because ironically at these meetups, technology always seems to fail me, and like the irony does not escape me. It's funny. It's very funny. So we'll see if that works, and if not, we have paper slips. Great. So I've done all this. So now we're gonna circulate this mic. And I just ask that you say your name, your role, where you're from, and maybe why you're here. I sometimes think that's really valuable, just to what's motivating you to be here, what do you maybe want to learn from this meetup. So we'll start over here with Heidi.
Hi everyone, I'm Heidi Massey. Hold it up or stand up.
Whoa.
Okay. I'm Heidi Massey, and I work for myself, and I work with a lot of businesses and nonprofits. I tend to focus on the digital space, but I do some strategic planning and things like that. I've always been really passionate about access to technology for different communities, and I've started getting into some anti-oppression work, which will also involve access to technology.
Hi everyone, my name is Alex Iskind. I'm the Program Associate at the Chicago Citywide Literacy Coalition. We are a member-based organization of different adult literacy nonprofits throughout the city. I'm interested in this topic specifically because right now we are convening a group of different adult literacy providers throughout the city to improve their technology infrastructure and also provide capacity building resources and professional development. And I know a lot of our organizations are always curious about where to get low-cost, free, updated technology, and so I'm really curious about the resources that you guys are going to be talking about today. Thank you.
Good morning. I am Leslie Dart. I am one of the project coordinators at the Smart Chicago Collaborative, and the projects under my purview are our health and education products, most notably the Youth Led Tech program.
Hello, I'm Phaedra Scott. I am the administrative assistant for Smart Chicago Collaborative, and I'm here to make sure you all get fed. Did I do a good job?
Yes.
Hey, Phaedra.
Good morning. My name is Maya. I live in South Shore, and I am not a computer whiz. I'm just here to really take in information because I'm a self-appointed community advocate for the kids on my block. It's been 6 years, and yay, I just have to give a shout out. I just got a partnership with Auditorium Theater, so I'm bringing 30 kids to experience a workshop and see the performance of the dance, Dance Theater of Harlem. So I'm really excited, and I'm just getting into a nonprofit mode and still working on the paperwork. But I'm here because a school, depressed school down the street from me, they were dumping computers, and I've seen my neighbors dump computers in the trash, and I just look like I know these could go somewhere, and I'm just here to just take all your expertise in and hopefully do something with it somehow, some kind of way in my community.
Hello everyone, good morning, can you hear me? Okay, good. I can't hear myself. My name is Calvin Goodman. I run a small managed service providership. Provide IT services for small businesses and a lot of not-for-profits in the Chicago area. I'm here today because we offer a lot of technology volunteer programs at our company, and we go out to nonprofits and we do projects with them to help update and upkeep their computer software and hardware maintained.
Thank you.
I'm Jenny Lockerby. I'm the Cyber Navigator Coordinator for the Chicago Public Library Foundation. I oversee 65 Cyber Navigators who work in 78 Chicago Public Library branches, and they provide digital skills, tutoring, and classes to library patrons. I'm here because I've heard through the Cyber Navigators that a lot of patrons are interested in buying refurbished devices and don't know where to go, so I'm excited to share out that information.
Hello everyone, my name is Soya Marziano. I'm the project coordinator here at Smart Chicago Collaborative. Like Denise, I'm also very excited that this is a meetup around devices. I think this is the very first one we've ever done, and that's just really just here to see all of you in the room to talk about this topic. It's also exciting, so thank you for being here.
Good morning, my name is Jack Stonebreaker. I'm an independent contract consultant working locally with communities to understand their needs in the digital adoption, digital inclusion space, and really letting that take me all over and create partnerships to support those needs, whether it's businesses, education, or just a technology center supporting the community.
Thank you. My name is Daniel Contreras. The name of my company is Optimista. We do technology workforce development and civic tech, primarily in partnership with Tina James from Greater Southwest, who's at the end there. And I love these meetups. So in addition to hearing information, Part of that opportunity here is to connect with each other. So I've been coming for the last 9 months or so. You know, part of what I do is I left 15 years of corporate IT for Accenture and BP to do workforce development in the southwest side of Chicago in an underserved community to expose primarily youth to technology and skills, jobs, careers. So in this meetup, there's just a lot of like-minded folks and opportunities to connect with folks to collaborate. So I take 40 seconds to kind of maybe give you an update. The meetup, some stuff that's come up just this year. So we met with the folks from Chicago Public Schools that run the CTE piece, and out of that, we did a summer program for Curie High School students that are taking web development to build a website with one of my web developers for a local nonprofit in the southwest side. And then we got a Chicago Community Trust on the table grant to help pay for some of the hosting costs, et cetera, which is really neat. Then we also met the CIO for the Park District in a meetup here a few months ago, and now we're working on a project with him. It's all volunteer-based to give youth opportunity to get a project, a technology workforce project. So I have four volunteers working on a virtual digital bulletin board that was going to roll out in 2017 throughout Chicago. And that kind of was birthed from our conversation here. And you know, got heard of the great Cyber Navigator work and, you know, the space we have in Archer Heights. We connected with a librarian, Elizabeth, at Archer Heights, and I'm working with Josie, the Cyber Navigator, there to connect. And Josie's convinced. So we had some great conversations. That's awesome. I didn't even see you there. So just 40 seconds of like some good stuff that's come out of here. And there's a few other things that it's in flight that we'll mention in a future meeting. So I love this forum. So thank
great.
You.
Great.
Hi, I'm Lexi Bowles. I am a Cyber Navigator over at Douglas Branch Library. I'm really excited about this program. I know that a lot of my patrons are not living in the most affluent areas of Chicago, and oftentimes worry that they don't have the opportunity to really learn their digital skills outside of the library. So being able to gather information on where they can possibly receive, you know, low cost devices so that they can continue their digital literacy is really exciting to me.
Hello everyone, my name is Josie. I'm also a cyber navigator at both Brighton Park and Archer Heights. I'm interested in this topic because I know plenty of patrons of mine who buy refurbished laptops and they crash. They buy them at Swamp Bahamas and other places, and they go back the next weekend and the person that sold it to them isn't there, and then they don't know what to do with these laptops, so they throw them out, and I feel bad. So I'd like to take whatever you guys can give me back to my patrons so that they have better resources.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday. My name is Rodolfo Calleros, and I'm a digital literacy instructor out of Instituto Progreso Latino, and I provide digitally challenged people with the skills they need to, especially nowadays when all the applications and all the jobs and all everything's done online. We got young and old, and they're like, why do I need an email? And it's the 21st century, like this is the way they're gonna see you. And we had, like I said, young and old, and it's just passing on digital literacy, and it's just not a luxury anymore, it's a necessity in today's day. So I'm here to learn and take from a lot of you your experience and take it back and pass it on to my students. And
my name is Rowan Talsma. I'm also a cyber navigator at the Salsa Regional Library on the north side of Chicago. We're a regional branch, so I see like hundreds of people every day, pretty much like all walks of life coming into my library. Some people have their own updated devices, but a lot of people are very reliant on the technology in the library, which, as we all know, is not always super reliable, ironically. So having more resources to share with people who are asking about buying their own devices but don't necessarily have like a lot of resources to get those devices, so that would be really useful.
I am outclassed. hey, I'm Matt with Free Geek Chicago. I do not have a formal title, so I just call myself that guy over there with the face. It's worked well for me. We're a nonprofit that deals with electronics recycling, mostly computer-related electronics. Have some other educational programs depending what comes in. Pretty much here just to learn, you know, what else is going on in the city, because we get a lot of questions and requests and things, and I have to figure out where to send people.
Hi, my name is Kristen Robinson. I'm a digital literacy instructor with the CARE program FOC in Bronzeville. I'm here because of that. I'm here because I'm a big fan of Denise Lynn.
It's and, mutual, Kristen. It's mutual.
And I'm also here because computer refurbishing, I've always wanted to make it over to Free Geeks, but the hustle and bustle of my life, I have not gotten a chance to make it over and refurbish my own computer. I actually ended up being involved in a situation where I got to go choose a computer, and when you talk about low-cost computers, that really opened my eyes. This was a couple weeks ago, and to see what's available for, like, let's just say under $500, $300 per se, and to know, like, my participants and students who I'm working with, like, to go in and say, oh, I have $300, I can afford a computer, and then, like, with my small savvy being like, oh, I'm at Best Buy, I would never buy that for $300, you know what I mean? Nothing towards Best Buy, but you know what I'm saying? Like, those are the kinds of things that I'm really passionate about, because it's all relative. So being able to refurbish my own, come up with ways to maybe put that in curriculum, to have tips on purchasing computers, those types of things are what I'm here to do. So thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Pat Maher. I'm Director of Civic Engagement with SPR Consulting. We're an IT solutions strategy company, but I'm here more as founder of IT Can. We're a group that meets monthly at the Microsoft Center, the MTC. We're hosted by Adam and Shelley and their staff, who are great. My focus is on candidates with disabilities, supporting them into tech, and I think there are many citizens in communities that are challenged, historically challenged socioeconomically, where a lot of these citizens probably have disabilities, whether diagnosed or otherwise, and I would, you know, I'm always looking to pull more folks into our membership at IT Can. It's a great platform for gaining exposure to knowledge broadly in the tech sector. And certainly this challenge of gaining access to reliable equipment as well as high-speed internet is one that afflicts the disability community broadly. So this is certainly of interest to me. Thanks.
Morning. My name is Nathan Williams, and I'm with technical support for a small nonprofit on the South Side called Planning Coalition, and I've been coming to the meetups for I guess beginning of the year, and always looking for something new to bring back to the nonprofit. And when this one came along, I said, "Wow, hardware! That's my ticket." So that's why I'm here.
Hello, I'm Barry Glicklick with Partners Bridging Digital Divide. We're a nonprofit based in DuPage County, and we are working for digital inclusion, trying to help connect agencies that are involved with providing training, providing low-cost computers, and providing internet connectivity. And I'm very excited to be here, make connections within Chicago, and look forward to working with you as we go forward.
Hi, I'm Steve Ettinger. I facilitate groups and organizations in ascertaining their goals and developing plans, strategic planning, and implementing those plans, especially in the IT arena. I'm also a regular participant at Chai Hack Night, something I invite everybody here to on Tuesday nights at the Merchandise Mart, chaihacknight.org. You can find out all about it. We build, develop, and share community tech, civic tech applications and websites and solutions. I'm also involved in establishing the Commons in Chicago. Commons is coming into vogue because we're recognizing that our current economy doesn't really work. And the Commons is built around sharing with each other, not sharing like in Uber or Airbnb, but in sharing like Chai Hack Night, where we get together and we build and share share our code and build solutions in the community. So if you're interested in any of those, contact me and I'll be happy to talk to you.
Hi, good morning. My name is Tina James. I'm from Greater Southwest Development Corporation. As an organization on the southwest side of Chicago, we have a lot going on in technology, actually. We've been privileged over the years to develop a Wi-Fi along the commercial corridor that we still support for local businesses and residents. We have, as Daniel mentioned, workforce development opportunities happening around technology. We also do quite a bit of technology training with small businesses, and I'll let Brian talk about Tech Thursdays that we do with small businesses. But it's our opportunity to partner with Connect Chicago and Microsoft and many of you when it comes to trying to figure out how do we bridge the digital divide, particularly on the south side, where we're interested in trying to invest and to reestablish ourselves in a solid way on the southwest side for residents and for businesses.
Good morning, my name is Brian Powers and I'm with the Chatham Technical Institute. I'm the executive director. Chatham Tech is focused on digital community development programming, providing those sorts of programs that are available to other nonprofit organizations to pull off the shelf and implement into their communities. When this came up, this information today about the Meetup or refurbished equipment, it was near and dear to me because my history in corporate America allowed me to decommission 30,000 units a year and repurpose those according to what was requested in the community from other nonprofit organizations. Interestingly, as we've had more and more issues with regard to the information that's being stolen, those units have become less and less available as major corporations are destroying completely the hard drives on these particular units. So where I was responsible for putting 30,000 of these on the street across the country to nonprofit organizations, now that's trickled down to very little. Now with bring your own device to work, we're buying less on the corporate side when it comes to hardware. So less and less becomes available. But for those folks that are interested in getting their hands on what I'd like to say are gently used pieces of technology, because it's coming out of your major financial institutions, they're in really good shape because of those maintenance contracts. I'd like to work with whoever's interested in that so we can create a real pipeline that will encourage corporate America to say it's worth the risk to provide the technology because the benefits outweigh the risk themselves.
Chicago Tech Community, alumni of IC Stars program, co-founder of Blue 1647, currently trying to open up a location in the Bronzeville area, and then I was coming out to find more about PC refer, how to partner with somebody that does that to have a Southside location, because most of them are either suburb or West Side of Chicago.
Good morning, everybody. Apologize for my tardiness. Downtown parking is a trip. My name is Sean Pinkston. I'm actually from the Ashburn community, 18th Ward. I am working with our alderman in our area to bring more technology and resources to our area. I also have a nonprofit organization, Top of the Key Sports Programs, where I bring sports for youth to our area, to various communities through the Park District. And we're looking to see how this program can actually benefit our community so that we can also acquire some of the resources that are available to other locations.
My name is Chris Paul. I'm an interested member of the community. I participate in Chai Hack Night. And I've been doing number crunching since college and grad school and a little bit for work. I go through a lot of computers and I just was interested in finding out where the two towers that I brought to PCR went. So that's where I'm here. Thanks.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Lee.
I'm 18 and I'm broken.
Good morning, everyone. This is Chakravarti here, and I'm in doing a research in the field. So I would like to get something out that you have this electronics come out into that field of giving the research to low cost of things and all those things in our student community. So that would really help me with this meetup. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you all so much for introducing yourselves. I'm also really pleased to hear that this was a very welcome topic. And this is something that's bubbled up through individual conversations. If there are other topics like this one that you feel like we're not talking about that you think should be a Connect Chicago meetup, please talk to me after. I would love to work with you to help plan that or uncover that topic we haven't been discussing. Also keep in mind, starting next year, Connect Chicago meetups will start to have a new format. We're going to have traditional meetups like this every other month here at the Chicago Community Trust, but then every other month we will have an offsite meetup. And so we started doing that, we did our first one last month, and we were in Bronzeville actually at a Chicago Housing Authority site. And we got to see some of their learning sites in person, and just really like be in the neighborhood and talk about technology. And so if you want to partner for an offsite meetup, if you're interested in that, or if you have recommendations or suggestions, please talk to me. That's something that we want to kind of plan for next year, and we want to plan with you. So great. So now, without further ado, I'm going to introduce Sarah, and I'll have her introduce herself while I pull up her presentation.
Hi, everyone.
Is this on? Can you hear me?
Yep.
All right. I'll have her pull up my slides, so I have my cheat sheet. We also sent out, and if you didn't print it out, we have them here for you. It's actually an article that I wrote that just walks through which device is best for you. So I oftentimes, when we talk to our customers, we say, you know, what are you going to be using this device for? And so they set, you know, will give us a list of things, and then that helps us to determine what actually will be the best fit for them. So some of our tips here are on this sheet, so please make sure you take one and feel free to use it. We'll probably post it online well.
I'm going to post it, so I'll post it and circulate it after the meetup as well. We can also just pass them around now, too, if you want.
Sure. There you go.
So today's presentation, I just was asked to give some information about how you should buy a refurbished device. Oftentimes we look at refurbished computers in our world as the same as buying a used car, right? So you just have to do a little bit of research, but certainly they're becoming more and more popular. So my goal was to come here and give you some of those tips. First, I'm going to do a little introduction about me, tell you a little bit more about our refurbishing facility, and then I'll go through my five tips. I also have a list of resources, website resources for you, and then we left some time for discussion and questions. So a little bit about me. First, I am the president of PC Rebuilders and Recyclers. I'm also the director of the Electronics Reuse Conference, which actually just ended on Wednesday. It's a three-day event that I plan every year for 350 refurbishers from all over the world that come together and share best practices. So I'm a little tired, but super energized, and everyone had a great time. We have about 35 people that present at that conference over the 3 days, and it's just really fun to be in a room with all people that do what you do, and there's some real great things that are shared and good relationships that are built. The interesting thing about our community, I would call it, is that we don't often consider ourselves as competitors, because a lot of the time we'll buy and sell from each other. So if I have a customer that wants a specific make and model of a computer and I don't have it, I'll call who would, you know, the person who would be my biggest competitor and say, hey, do you have any of these that I can refurbish and give to my customer? So everyone is actually pretty friendly, which is nice, because we want to all make sure that we're doing the best job and creating a good brand for refurbished computers out there, and not just for PCR. So that's actually the main reason that I'm here today, is to help you guys understand what really you should be looking for in a quality refurbished computer. I also sit on the technical advisory committee for the Responsible Recycling Standard. That's an electronics recycling standard, and there's about 600 recyclers worldwide that are a part of that group, and my role is to play the reuse cheerleader. So I get on there with all these big smelters and, you know, big recyclers and shredders, and I'm like, wait, how about we reuse it before we recycle it? And that's a pretty fun job. I'm also sit on the board of directors for another standard called RIOS. RIOS is an employee health and safety and quality standard for recyclers as well. So those two sort of interplay. And those two standards I implemented at our facility, which if you've ever implemented a quality standard, you will know how much work that is. I also am lucky and get to do a lot of presentations and trainings all around the world on behalf of Microsoft and their reuse program. So I've been able to go to Africa twice, to Ireland, and actually in a few weeks I'll be headed off to Macau. So I love talking about reuse. So that is just a little bit about me. About PCRR, so a lot. I feel like some of you are pretty familiar with us, which I'm pretty excited about. We started in Chicago in 2000, and this is a story that I love to tell because my father started our company, and it's because we actually hosted a student to go to St. Ignatius, which is a Catholic high school just up here on Roosevelt, and it's through a program called Link Unlimited, and Link believes that if you give children access to quality education, then they'll be able to get college scholarships. And so giving them that access earlier, you know, is phenomenal. And Willie, and you'll hear me talk about my dad as Willie when we're in work settings. But don't worry, at home I still call him Dad. And so Willie sat on the board of directors at that time. And he, our student, Gerald, was just a year older than I was at Ignatius. And he came home one day with a bad grade on his report card. And my parents were like, hey, what the heck? And Gerald, you know, gave the story of, which we've all been there. I was in the computer lab, almost done with my paper. The computer crashed, the lab closed, and he had to go home. And it was due first period. And, you know, my parents being the saints that they are, instead of being mad at him for not starting it earlier, they said, you know, these kids don't have a chance to compete against the other kids at Ignatius if they don't have computers in their homes. And he said this at a board meeting, and luckily there was a COO of a large garbage company there at the same time. And this is 1996, so it's, you know, it's that's a pretty radical thinking back then. And the waste management company said, I have a room full of computers I don't know what to do with. You can have them. So it was the coldest day of my life in February. And Gerald and I and some of our friends and my dad, obviously, rented a budget truck, went down, picked up all of these computers, and brought them back to my parents' basement. And now, mind you, remember, 1996, we're not talking about like cute little laptops that we're bringing back, right? Like, we're talking big, white CRT monitors. So we brought them back to the basement. My dad started working on them. He was doing some time management consulting at the time, so, you know, he was really teaching himself along the way, but quickly realized that, you know, it's actually more, the problem is actually the software and not the hardware, right? The hardware pieces actually are pretty easy to piece together if you've got them all. But the software is where things get difficult. So then him and some friends in the refurbishing industry that he met through networking, started working with Microsoft to create what is now known as the Microsoft Registered Refurbisher Program. So we'll talk a little bit more about that in a few minutes, but that is the story of how we started. Now we're in 30,000 square feet, so we have a few more computers than we did that first day. We have 25 full-time employees. We do a lot of job training for ex-offenders. It's something that's sort of near and dear, close to my parents' heart. And so we are on the west side of the city. We do about 20,000 computers in a year, and most of our customers are nonprofits or schools or homes of at-risk children. But then, of course, we do sell on major retail sites like Newegg and Amazon and Walmart and those places too. So that's a little bit about us. Any questions about us? No? Okay. So I thought I'd start with, why should you buy a refurbished computer? And you, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name, but you made a really great point. Kristen. You made a great point, is that the computers that you see at Best Buy that are $300, those are consumer grade equipment, right? If you're gonna buy a refurbished product from me or any of the other Microsoft authorized refurbishers or, you know, registered refurbishers, you're gonna get business grade equipment, because what we take in is off-lease computer equipment that was just used for a couple of years in the corporate environment, and then that's when we upgrade the hardware and the software. So even if you're spending the same dollar amount, even if you're spending $250 or $200 or $300 on a computer, you're getting something that actually is, that hardware itself was built to last around 10 years. The software for any of the refurbishers then is gonna be brand new based on some of the tips that I'll go through. And yeah, I use that joke a lot that it's just well-tested equipment. Of course, for if you're buying it here locally through us or getting it through people like Free Geek, you're going to be promoting local jobs and sustainability. And if, you know, last but certainly not least, we know that in the world of recycling, reuse is the number one component. So if people aren't using those computers, they should be reused before they're recycled. And just as a note, in the state of Illinois, it is illegal to throw out electronic equipment. So if you hear that, tell them, please don't do that. Yeah.
So my question is, because the school, somebody, my neighbors have done this twice. I actually put it in the grocery cart and rolled it to the school because I said, here, just, they don't want it. I think it's in great condition to look at. And then the IT guy was like, we can't take this. And so when I called about I just called randomly a company that said they could do it. I had to pay them $100 to come pick it up from South Side of Chicago, and I left it with him, but I knew he was just going to throw it back in the dumpster. And so it's like, I don't, just being in my community, I can put it in my house, but I don't know where to take it. Now I do, I can. I didn't know where to take it, and they just...
You know, the recycling world is really changing for electronics, and I could probably talk about that for a long time, but just quickly, the hard part is that because commodity prices have been dropping for so many years steadily, that now it has actually cost money to recycle a computer, whereas in the past you could make money or break even. And so there's a lot of turmoil around it, and there will be people that should charge you, unfortunately, for recycling it. There are a couple places where you can drop it off for free, but you want to do some due diligence to make sure that those companies have the correct certification so that you're insured that they actually are recycling it and not just getting rid of it.
I'll find that out later.
Yeah.
I want to ask you, you keep saying to reuse it first, then recycle. So what exactly do you mean by that? If somebody has a computer and they want to
reuse it? So companies like mine will take computers that corporations don't want or individuals don't want. And we have specific, you know, what we call a tech cut line. So if there's a piece of equipment that meet these specifications, we will upgrade the hardware and then add brand new operating systems on them.
As opposed to recycling it.
Recycling it is literally taking it apart in pieces, shredding it all up, and melting it all down. Yeah. Yeah. Which eventually has to happen to it all, but. So my five tips when buying refurbished computers. The first one is to be aware of what software is included. So I've talked about the Microsoft refurbisher programs. There are two programs for Microsoft. So there's the registered refurbisher program, which has about 6,500 organizations worldwide as members. It is a free program that you can join, and it gives you access to discounted licenses. So if you want to be a refurbisher, that is the first step. All for nonprofits, if you are reselling these computers to a nonprofit or to a school, you pay $6 for Windows 10. If you are selling it commercially, you buy it from a distributor and you pay more. But if you are working with schools or nonprofits, it's $6. There are then larger refurbishers like myself. There are about 80 of us in the world. All of us do more than 20,000 in a year. And we have access to those same, what they call citizenship $6 licenses. And then we also have access to a few other things because we're a little bit bigger and bigger partners with them. So there is a huge network of refurbishers that do Microsoft refurbishing, but if you are working with a refurbisher and you're going to get a Microsoft product, in order to make sure that that is genuine software, you want to make sure that they are on this list. And I will give you a list of the directory. You can go to refurbishedpcs.com. There's a directory that lists all of the refurbishers that are a part of this program. Any questions about that? You'll want to also ask questions about what other software is included. Microsoft also has Security Essentials, which is a free antivirus if you have a genuine license. And so oftentimes that's a good option for people who, you know, don't want to pay, you know, an annual or a monthly fee for some of the other antivirus software, but you want to still make sure that their system is protected. A lot of the times we find that new users just don't know that they need to have that, right? And they don't know that it doesn't come with their computer, or it may or may not come with their computer. So those are sort of some big questions that you want to answer. There's also options, Linux options. So Free Geek here and in Portland do Linux-based machines. And so, you know, again, that's a free option, which is phenomenal. It looks a little bit different than Microsoft, so sometimes that's a little bit hard for people. But you know, again, asking the question of what software is included, you know, what is it going to be able to do for me, and making sure that they're including genuine licensing is one of the most important things that you can do. Because what happens when you don't have a genuine license is you don't get updates, right? That's the worst, because then you have a higher chance of getting a virus, you have a higher chance of your computer not working, and then that's probably what happened to your individual that bought it from the swap meet, right? They couldn't update the system, and then it's just not gonna be able to work for them. It doesn't mean that they won't get a virus. People always seem to get viruses. So number one is to make sure you understand what software is included. Any questions about that? Good. Number two is you want to understand what the guarantee is. And I always talk about the guarantee really in three different areas. So one, what's the warranty that the refurbisher is going to provide to you? You'll notice on Amazon requires a minimum of 30 days. And for its certified refurbishers, for Amazon certified refurbishers, I think it's 90 days. We often will do a year to 3 years for some of our desktops. It sort of depends on what our customers are asking for, but that's our standard for most of our schools and nonprofits. But understand how it works, right? And understand if you have a problem that you actually have to tell them this so that they can fix it, right? So if you've got a computer and it's not working, you know, how do you contact them? Is it an email? Is it a phone? What do you have to do to make sure that you can get your computer working again? You know, it's technology's great until it doesn't work, right? And then it's frustrating for everybody. It doesn't matter if you're a new user or if you've been using it since you were a child. If it doesn't work for you, it's annoying. So make sure that you understand if there's a problem, you know, how do you contact them to get it resolved? And it, you know, knowing if it's a hardware issue or a software issue is really important. So a lot of the Microsoft refurbishers will include a restore partition on our units, so that if you do download a virus, my technical support guy can walk you through how to restore it back to the original settings, so you're not bringing the computer, you know, into us to reimage it. You can just fix it over the phone. So that sort of brings us into what I call technical support. So if you've got a question about your computer, you think something is wrong, you know, who do you ask? How do you do that? You've got to make a call. Do you have to send an email? Does it have a restore options? All these things are important things to know when you're buying your computer, so that if something does happen, you're prepared to be able to make sure that you can, you know, to still use it. And then also understand your return policy. So if a computer comes in, you know, you get your computer and it's just not what you thought was going to be, or it's a little bit heavier than you wanted it, I mean, whatever it may be, is there a return policy, and is there a fee associated with that, you know, all those sorts of things. We'll talk in a minute, but if you are buying a computer from an R2 certified company, all of these, the warranty and the return policy are required within that standard. So you'll know that they're there. You have to ask them how long, of course, each one is, but you do know that they are included in that.
And those are written policies that are available when you purchase the product.
Yeah, yeah. It should either be on your invoice. We always include them on our invoice. Also, they could be on their website, or we also include a user manual that has like details about how to do all that. Yeah.
Does your restore option just re-image the system, or does it save data?
It's a good question. Windows 10 is now different. So in Windows 10, it's either revert, re-image, or there's one other R word.
Recovery,
thank you. And so they now do have the option to do that. The problem with the Windows 10 restore is that the Windows 7 restore let them restore it when they didn't have a password. But now in Windows 10, they have to have the user password in order to restore it, which I can't tell you how many people are like, I don't remember my password. And we're like, well, You gotta remember. That's the one thing you gotta remember. So Windows 10, it does save data if you choose it to. Yeah. Good question though. And just as a side note, the Microsoft refurbisher programs, as of Monday, they are end of lifing Windows 7. So we are no longer allowed to buy Windows 7 licenses. We can only buy and sell Windows 10 products. It's not end of support for Windows 7 from Microsoft. It's just we can't sell them anymore. So that's actually a good barometer. If you're buying a computer online, you actually probably should make sure that it's Windows 10, because it may or may not be outside of the Microsoft program. Good. So number three is, how do they do it? So when I was talking about certifications earlier,